नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज बायो रिएक्टर्स। नाउ व्हाट आर बायो रिएक्टर्स? बायो रिएक्टर्स दैट आर वेरी लार्ज टैंक्स और वेसल्स व्हिच आर बेसिकली यूज्ड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द डिजायर्ड प्रोडक्ट। सो इन दीज वेसल्स द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, द प्लांट सेल्स और इवन द एनिमल सेल्स, ह्यूमन सेल्स दैट कैन बी कल्चर्ड, which are responsible for converting the raw materials into the desired product. So bioreactors, they are of two types. First, that is simple stirred tank bioreactor, and second, that is the sparger. So let's discuss in detail. Basically, the bioreactors that are used for the production of the desired product in large quantity, like around 100 to 1000 liter quantity if we require, then the bioreactors that are used. Now you can see here that this vessel, it consists of curved, it is curved at the bottom. Okay, so that is the main difference between the simple stir tank bioreactor and the second type, that is the sparger. In case of sparger, they are flat from the bottom reason, and you can see that the blades that are present, okay, the blades that are present in the vessel and the motor that is present at the upper reason, and these blades that are not present in case of the sparger type bioreactor. So because of this motor, what happened, this blade, it will get rotated. So when this blade, it will rotate, then what happened, the medium which is present here in the bioreactor, okay, medium means the cultural growth, the raw materials that we will provide in the vessel, okay, that is converted by the microorganisms. As what we have to take in these bioreactors, first, that is microorganisms or cells of the plants and animals. Second, that is the broth that we have to culture, the medium which has the nutrients, okay, which is also known as the raw material here. So these two things we have to take, and the third is the optimum conditions that are required. The optimum conditions should be there in the bioreactor. If suppose for the beer production, okay, that we discussed in the chapter 10th, microbes in human welfare. So what we have discussed in that Saccharomyces cerevisiae, this microorganism that is responsible for the production of the beer, okay. So in this bioreactor, we have to take the microorganism as well as the raw material. Raw material that will be fruit juices or molasses for that, okay. And optimum conditions. Optimum conditions means the pH, the temperature, it should be optimum for what? For the growth of the microorganisms. Okay, so this is one example. We can take any other example also, like for the production of the insulin hormone. Okay, so like E. coli microorganisms we have to take for that. So in case of microorganisms, we will take E. coli, and then in case of cultural medium, we have to take the medium that is required for the growth of the E. coli. Now this E. coli, they contain the insulin gene. Okay, so some amount of, means some quantity of E. coli cells we have to provide to the bioreactors with the cultural growth, and the optimum conditions we have to provide. And then what happened, the E. coli, it will rapidly divide and produce number of E. coli cells. Okay, so if the E. coli cells, they will divide, then the insulin gene which is present in them, that will also divide. And insulin gene after transcription and then translation, what it will produce? It will produce the insulin hormone. Okay, so that insulin later on we can isolate when it is produced in the liters. Okay, so for the quantity that we required for 100 to 1000 liter, means if suppose we require the desirable product in this quantity, for that purpose the bioreactors that are used, and it is used basically for the production of the enzymes, proteins and the other, okay, other desirable products. So let's discuss the structure of the bioreactor. So it is curved from the bottom region, okay, and the blades that are present, and these are known as the impellers. These are known as impellers. And what is the function of the impeller? That when the cultural growth, that when the cultural growth that is provided, okay, so the function of impeller is to mix, to mix the growth with the oxygen. Means like from here, this region we are providing the sterile air. Sterile air means the oxygen we are providing from here, which is sterile. So this oxygen that is mixed with the broth, so that the microorganisms, they are able to take the oxygen. The oxygen supply that will become uniform. Uniform means that in the overall bioreactor, the oxygen supply that will be uniform by the help of the impeller. Impellers, they mix. They mix the content that is present in the bioreactor. Okay. Now next is the foam breakers. So as the mixing will be there by the help of the blades, so that the oxygen, it will be available to all the microorganisms, the cells. So foam that is created. Okay. So if foam will be there, then the microorganisms, they will not be able to take the oxygen. So that's why the upper impellers, they are responsible for the breaking of the foam. Okay. And the cultural growth, it should be up to 3/4. The level of the cultural growth, it should be 3/4. Why? So that when the foam that is created, that foam, it should be breaked by the impellers. That can be breaked by the impellers present at the upper region. Okay, clear? So if suppose this will be the level, then the bioreactors, they will work efficiently. Okay, so this is all about the air, culture medium, impellers. Next is that optimum temperature as well as optimum pH that is also required. Okay, if suppose the pH that is more, okay, means it is basic in nature, then the acid that will be added through this region. And if suppose the medium that is very acidic, then the base, it will be added through this region. But how we will come to know that the sample that is present in the bioreactor that is acidic or basic in nature? Because one term is there, that is sampling port in your book. Okay, what is the meaning of that? That time to time we can remove the culture, little amount of culture we can remove for testing, that what conditions are there and what type of conditions we need there. Okay, means we know that what kind of conditions, what kind of pH and temperature that is required. So by after testing, we provide that optimum pH and temperature. Okay, so this is all about the pH control, that how the pH that can be controlled. But the temperature that can also be controlled. Okay, so from here, the thermometer that is dipped here in the sample, in the cultural growth. And through this, we will be able to come to know about the temperature. If suppose the temperature that is very high, for that reason a water jacket that is present here, a jacket that is surrounding, that surrounds the bioreactor, and water it circulates in this jacket. Water it circulates in this jacket. So, and if suppose the temperature that is very less than the hot water that is introduced through these inlets, okay, and even the steam that is also provided for sterilization, that is the first step, means before starting the process, the sterilization will be there of the bioreactors. So let's see again. It is a large vessel and it consists of the impellers, blades. Okay, and what is the function of the blades here? To mix the broth, to mix the cultural broth with the oxygen that is supplied through the inlet that is present here. Okay, so that the microorganisms, the plant cells or even the animal cells, they will get the oxygen uniformly. Even they are present in this region or here, wherever they are present. Okay, and the level it should be up to 3/4. And what is the function of these foam breakers? That if the foam that are created, means that are produced because of the mixing of the cultural broth by the bladers. So what happened? These foam breakers, they break the foam. Okay, because if suppose foam will be there, then the microorganisms, they will not be able to take up the oxygen. Then if suppose they are not able to take up the oxygen, then what happened? They are not able to produce the desirable product. Okay, and from here the pH that is controlled, and through the jackets the water that is circulated to maintain the temperature, and from here steam that is provided for the sterilization purpose. In this manner the microorganisms, they are responsible for the production of the desirable product, and then after that, during the downstream processing, these products that are isolated from these cells by the process of centrifugation, and then purification will be there, and then after testing trials it will come in the market for the commercial purpose. Now we will discuss about the second type of the bioreactor, that is Paget type. Now what is the difference between the two, that is simple stirred tank bioreactor and this Paget type of the bioreactor? In case of the simple tank, this bottom that is of curved shape, but here in this case, in this Paget, it is flat. And one more thing, that the blades and the impellers that are present in case of the simple tank, but in case of this, the blades that are not present for the mixing of the broth, here the broth that is mixed because of this Paget that is present. And this Paget, it consists of holes. So when the sterile air, it is passed through this, then what happened? The air, it will come in the form of bubbles that are produced. These bubbles, they contain the air, and because of that, as the bubbles that are created in this tank everywhere, so the microorganisms or the cells which we are culturing in the bioreactor, they are very efficiently take up the oxygen through these bubbles. And the other things like the optimum conditions related to the pH, temperature, steam that is provided, so that things that are provided in this case also. Okay, so basically the principle that is same for the conversion of the raw materials into the desirable product like enzymes or hormones, proteins, etc. So when the desirable products that are produced, then the next step, that will be the downstream processing. So next, that is the downstream processing. What happens in this case, that first of all the separation will be there. Separation of what? Separation of the microorganisms because when the bioreactors, in the bioreactors, the microorganisms, they produce the desired product. Okay, then what will remain at last? At last, the microorganisms with having the desired product as well as some medium, the growth that is present in that. So the desired product, it has to be separated, it has to be isolated from the microorganisms. So this process is known as separation. And how it can be done? It can be done through centrifugation. Now the next step, that is purification. It should be in pure form, means if any of the macromolecules that is attached with the desired product, so on that basis the enzymes that are given so that the purification of the desired product will be there. Now third is that adding preservatives. Not in all cases, but wherever it is required, like for the production of the food products or for the production of the drinks, so in that cases the preservatives that are added, okay, so that we can use them for a longer period of time. And in case of drugs, testing trials will be there. Various testing trials will be there to know about their chemical composition. To identify their side effects, their effects over the body. So there are different trials will be there. So after crossing these testing trials, these desirable products, they are available in the market for the commercial purpose.